love the music.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. As you can see, I'm not Beverly Sills. And it may be even harder for you to believe, but I'm also not James Levine. As a matter of fact, Maestro Levine is backstage right now, holding my violin, and if you want to know which one is which, the one with the violin is Maestro Levine. The one without the violin is myself. However, when I get the violin from him, then I will be the one who is not Maestro Levine. He will be the one with it. So, Maestro Levine, please.
I
Well, did you straighten them out about which one of us is which?
I'm sure I didn't, actually. But I think right now we are about ready to say, will the real Itzhak Perlman please sit down? All right, so and by the way, we have to say what we're going to play.
What are we going to play?
We're going to play the Tsigaynerweisen by Sarasate. So.
You take this, and I'll take that. You take this, and I'll take that. Thank you.
Thank you. Williams for the movie Schindler's List. And the first is called Remembrances, and the second one is just called The Theme from Schindler's List.
Escucharemos ahora algunas de las composiciones favoritas de Isaac Perlman, escritas por John Williams para la lista de Schindler, Remembranzas y el tema principal de la película.
Thank you. Now, that endearing theme is played by Itzhak Perlman with John Williams and the Boston Pops Orchestra.
A Nocturne in C sharp minor, transcription by Nathan Milstein.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. 42. Door keer. Door keer. Als ik heb hem zeker. Boer
Yum yum.
Yum yum.
Mord ga gebürtig, da geboren a Krucke war. Er hat geschrieben, was Sachlieder, paar hundert Lieder, in viel Texten, und allein gesingen, und allein gespielt, das ist wie ein Stoller.
Ja.
Ich bin ein Stoller, nicht wie ein Musiker. Nur, er hat ihn importiert in Lager Kabelsitz, er hat ihn geschossen auf der Gas.
Ja.
Danach hat ihn gefunden, alle seine Lieder.
Ja, so du hörst, ja, sehr, sehr schöne
Lieder. Sehr schöne Lieder, wunderbare Lieder. Ja.
Reisel hat geschrieben.
Reisel hat umgeschrieben für seine Tochter.
A lot of people say, why do you keep doing the Holocaust and mentioning it over and over again? It's important. We went on a little trips, you know, in little places that used to have just so many people, you know, so many Jews live there, and it's just all gone. Certainly we cannot get all our people back, but maybe we can get more memories, can get more feelings. so that we don't forget. And that's really the most important thing, is that we cannot forget. There's so many beautiful synagogues in Krakow, so beautiful, and yet without people, without Jewish melody.
Thank you. Thank you.
play for you Introduction and Tarantella by Sarasate.
So September 13th, I'm going to be playing at the Hollywood Bowl, and I wanted to talk to you about what I was going to play, which is the Tchaikovsky Violin Concerto. Now, the Tchaikovsky Violin Concerto is, you know, probably one of the three, four most played concertos for the violin. You've got Beethoven, Brahms, Mendelssohn, and Tchaikovsky. I would say those are the main four. You know, some people will say Sibelius, Dvorak, and so on, but the main four is what I've just said. I've been associated with the Tchaikovsky Concerto for a very long time. You know, 1964, when I won the Levantrit competition, I played the Tchaikovsky Violin Concerto when I was, oh, I can't remember, 18 years old. Quite a long time ago. Anyway, it's the thing about Tchaikovsky that's so wonderful is that he has his heart on his sleeve. It's very sentimental. It's not pretentious. Melodically, you know, when you think about, oh, you know, that there's absolutely unabashed romanticism. Of course, it's quite virtuoso. It's very, very difficult in the sense that, well, there are two types of difficulty. There is technical difficulty that you can solve when you practice. And then there's difficulty that is discomfort. The Tchaikovsky Concerto is, in many ways, uncomfortable to play. And no matter how much you practice it, it's always a little bit uncomfortable. You can play it, but it's never like even the Paganini Concerto, which is a much more virtuoso, well, a technically virtuoso piece, that you can solve very, very quickly, you know, because you can just practice it slowly and in rhythms, and you got it. With the Tchaikovsky, it's always a little uncomfortable. You know, all of that stuff, that's always very uncomfortable. Of course, if you practice in rhythms and if you practice slowly, as I always preach to my students, you can solve that problem. But anyway, I'm looking forward to playing this piece. It's a great piece, and I'll be there at the Hollywood Bowl.
You know, violinists love to play chamber music, but we don't often get to improvise. So this is a wonderful chance for me to play a little chamber jazz. I'm here with the Modern Jazz Quartet, John Lewis on piano, Milt Jackson on vibraharp, Percy Heath on bass, and on drums, Connie Kay. You know, we've played together before, and the Modern Jazz Quartet graciously agreed to give me another chance. So, thank you. And can we do something that I know? Let's say, can we do a little Gershwin? Let's do a little Gershwin. Okay. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.